Have you ever wanted to look at live streaming pre-recorded content over to Facebook Live or to YouTube Live? Well, that's what I'm going to show you how to do today with a new platform called Live Reach. My name's Krishna Day. You'll find me online at krishna.me, and I cover a lot of video marketing tools and technologies, but I also have a weekly live stream all about live streaming tools, technologies, and case studies. So I was really excited to have the opportunity to take a look at this new platform. I've already given it access to my Facebook account and my YouTube account. And when you do so, you'll be able to choose, for example, on Facebook, which groups you want to have it access, if you want to have it access your pages, and again, specific pages that you want to be able to publish to. What I've done in terms of actually setting this up, I'm actually working on desktop on a PC. This software is also available for Mac. So it doesn't work in your browser, as I've covered in other tools, in terms of which you can find on krishna.me, which allows you to schedule pre-recorded content. And that could be pre-recorded live video, or it could be just recorded video that you've got. In this case, I'm actually going to do a test over to Facebook. And so what I've got here is there's a video title here that originally comes in terms of your title as the title of the video that you've got on your hard drive that you upload. So I've actually just changed that title. I can now select the page that I wanted to go to. So I've got several pages, and with this drop down area, I can select the specific page. I also can add a thumbnail, which is really important for Facebook to be able to have an engaging cover image that actually will tell people what the event is about. In here, I've actually been able to play the video to make sure it plays okay. And I've just got it screenshotted here in terms of at one particular point. I can set the quality, so I've set this to 720p, so I've got high definition recording already, and so what I want to do is stream it at 720 over onto Facebook. Over on the right hand side, it then gives me options. Now here it says public set to everyone. That's as a default in terms of on my page anyway, because obviously you can't have too much custom kind of planning of your sharing options on your page. Of that could of course be different if you're on a profile. So on your profile, you can say, if I was testing it only to me, or I could say friends or friends of friends. I can now schedule it. So I can have it set out immediately now, or I can schedule it in the future. So that's really handy if I actually want to set it at another time. So just let me leave it as that. And then I can put a little post description in here, which I've done. So always when you're sharing a live stream on Facebook, put a description in there. You then have a little terms of set service message. This is important because Facebook do want you to be very explicit if you're not streaming live content live. So if you're sharing pre-recorded live video or recorded video, you actually need to make sure people know. And so this is really good that the developers have added this in. And so here I can put my terms of service message, and I can decide what language it wants to be in. I can also say whether or not this was previously recorded. So here I can say previously recorded, recorded live on, recorded on, or aired recently. So I'm actually just going to leave this as previously recorded. And then I can make a decision about when that information needs to be positioned in terms of a message. So before or after the description of my stream. So I'm going to leave it into after. And with that, that's all I need to do in terms of setting up this live stream to go out. It's pre-recorded content. I've been clear about that being said. What I can do now is just click on schedule. Let's take a quick look at what it looks like on YouTube. In terms of for the YouTube setup, again, my video has already been uploaded. I've changed the title of it here. I can set what resolution I want the video to be in. I can also then set up in terms of who do I want that content to be seen by. I can also set the schedule time, and I can post a description. So I hope you found that a helpful quick overview in terms of how to set up pre-recorded video content, which could have been a live video or it could have just been recorded video, as a live stream to Facebook and to YouTube. I hope that was a helpful overview in terms of how to prepare your videos for restreaming, in terms of it was pre-recorded live stream or live streaming it, in terms of it being content that you've already recorded over onto Facebook and to YouTube. If you do have any questions about this, please don't hesitate to reach out to me at krishna.me. Do make sure, however, you check out the Facebook and YouTube terms, or any terms of platforms that you're streaming to make sure that your content complies with their requirements.